Hello everyone, Miss Lasseter here, and in today's video I wanted to do a quick list of 10 things I wish I knew before I became a biology major. As some of you probably have heard before, my undergraduate degree is in biology, and this video is not meant to deter you in any way from becoming a biology major. I think it's a great major to study. I think there's a lot of really awesome career options, and the opportunities and things you'll learn as a biology major are really amazing. But there are some things and skills that I wish I knew ahead of time going into my major that would have made life a little bit easier as I pursued this major in college. So I'm imparting this knowledge to you today because a lot of you who watch this channel do want to go on to become biology majors someday. So I'm giving you these 10 things that I wish I knew before I started my studies in biology in college. Number one, go to your professor's office hours. Now, I have a whole video on this, so I'm not gonna spend too much time ranting on it because I think it is so important, both in high school and in college, but I was somebody in high school who didn't go to teachers for help because I felt that that was a sign of weakness, when in turn, there are so many opportunities that get open to you and things you can learn from going to professor's office hours. It is not a sign of weakness. In fact, it is much better to be seen and to develop a relationship with your teachers and your professors than not to go. Start asking for help and start chatting your professors up in office hours as early as you can, especially if you are majoring in biology. In high school, I was a fairly good reader. I took AP Biology. I did very well in the course. I thought, okay, I'm a high schooler taking a college level course. It can't get much harder than that in college, right? Well, no. Reading and highlighting books and using my same high school study strategies that had made me a successful high school student just didn't cut it. So my number two thing, passive studying strategies are not going to cut it for you in a college level biology course, especially as you get into the more difficult content. A lot of what you learn is going to need to be applied and understood and viewed in several different times before you actually learn and understand it. The other thing too, if a professor mentions something in class, assigns it for homework, or it's buried somewhere in the reading, all of that could be fair game for one of your tests. So do make sure you cover everything that you can and you have a good understanding of everything that is in the syllabus and presented to you, because you may be accountable for that work even if you didn't spend a lot of time on it in your class lecture. Number three, there is a lot of chemistry as a biology major. Most college programs will require you to take several chemistry courses as part of your biology major's requirements. So if you're somebody who's interested in majoring in biology but you didn't like chemistry in high school, well, too bad. You're gonna have to take more chemistry and really have a good understanding of chemistry as well. And the things you learn in chemistry may be skills you'll need later on if you go into a lab or you use it in a career or you go into medicine. So just make sure you're aware of all of the chemistry requirements that your program and your major is gonna require as part of your biology major. Number four, there are a lot of pre-med students. Now, if you're someone who is a pre-med student who plans on majoring in biology, that is totally fine. You don't need to change to be different from other people. So if you are not aware, a lot of other biology majors will be focused on that pre-med track, getting those pre-med requirements out of the way to take the MCAT, doing everything that they can to prepare themselves for a good, strong medical school application. If this isn't you, that's fine. Just know that a lot of your peers may be involved in that path and may be super focused on that in your biology program. This also can mean that some of your courses are very competitive because people are competing for high GPAs to get into those graduate programs, medical school, dental school, etc. Which brings me to number five. In some larger universities like the one I went to, there are a lot of weed out classes at the lower levels of courses you have to take. For example, Bio 101 was often a class that was considered a weed out class for people because biology was so popular as a major. There were so many people taking biology that sometimes those introductory courses were intentionally made very challenging in order to discourage people from pursuing the majors unless they really wanted it that way. Now, I'm not saying this is the case in every program, but it is the case for some universities, especially those who have a large percentage of students coming in who identify as pre-med. So just be aware that some of your earlier courses in your biology program may be very challenging and it may lower your GPA. Number six is something that actually I did discover pretty early on as I was a biology major, but research is a great opportunity. No matter what career path you are interested in after college, if you're a biology major, you should try to get into a lab at some point during your college career. I was fortunate enough to be a work study student in a pharmacology lab during my undergraduate program, and that was a really amazing experience to see science firsthand to help out the other scientists and to get an understanding of what a laboratory career would be like. I found out very early on that I didn't want to do that for myself as my career path, but it's good to identify whether or not you'd think you'd be a good fit. I also felt like there were skills in my laboratory work that I was able to apply to my coursework, and I could see the real life applications of a lot of things we were learning in class. The scientists in the lab were very helpful and supported throughout my entire undergraduate study. Number 7. This came as a surprise to me, but in a lot of college science classes, there's not much that's graded besides tests. Many biology classes that I took had 4 tests throughout the year, and the lowest one was dropped. You may think that sounds really great and exciting because you could do poorly on one test and then your average only came from the other 3 tests, but it didn't exactly work out that way because the tests were very, very challenging and you went through the semester thinking, okay, maybe this one will be the one I drop. Oh, maybe this one will be the one I drop. And it turns into a very scary numbers game that makes these tests very stressful and high stakes throughout the year. So if you're someone who's not a strong test taker, be aware that a lot of your grade is going to be based on tests and not projects or papers, especially in the lower level science classes. Which brings me to number 8. Some of my classes were huge. Again, biology was the most popular major at my college when I studied there, and so there were so many other students in my lectures. These were classes that were held in huge lecture halls. Sometimes I would have to get a seat way in the back, and it was very hard to develop a relationship with the professors or ask questions or even feel a real connection to the course sometimes. It wasn't until I got into my higher level biology coursework where I really felt like I could interact well in the class and talk to the professors and form good relationships with people in the class as well. It may be a little different and disappointing for some of you, especially if you've come from a high school program where you do enjoy having a space where you can interact with the teacher and ask questions and feel really a part of the class. It also makes it really easy to fade into the background and not really be a part of the class. And if you're somebody who is tempted to sleep in or skip classes or not turn in your work, it's all the more easier in a class with hundreds of other students. So number 9, I wish I had done this earlier too, is you really should try to form relationships with other students in your class and form study groups. It is good to have a core group of people that you work with and study with that you can do problem sets with, again, so that you can work on active studying strategies together and not just rely on reading and highlighting your textbook, which is not the best way to learn the material. With study groups, you can also talk out things that you might not understand or get ideas for resources or places to go or things that they might have tried if you're getting stuck in a class. But especially in the sciences, study groups are one of the best ways to improve your coursework, and I wish I would have done this sooner as a biology major. All right, and my number 10 thing that I wish I would have known before I became a biology major is that it does take a lot of time. Not only was there a lot of coursework that I had to complete, and there were semesters where I had to overload in order to get all my major stuff done, many of you are in high school and you're super motivated and you're involved in a lot of challenging coursework and clubs and extracurriculars, and when you go to college, you get excited because there's so many more opportunities for you than your high school had. You want to try all the things. It's really not possible to do well in a biology program as a biology major and do every single extracurricular out there. I got very involved in some of my extracurriculars, but I realized as I went on in my junior and senior years, I had to cut back on some of those activities to devote time to my coursework. Biology isn't something that you're just going to be able to get the first time around. It's going to take time to study. You're going to need to go to those study groups and office hours and do the laboratory requirements and try research out of class. And so all the things that you might have wanted to do extracurricular wise, you're going to have to place on the back burner unless it's something that you really want to devote yourself to. So pick a few really important things that you love. One of mine was the marathon club in college, so I did that a lot. But then the other clubs I was more a participant of and I wasn't a part of their leadership. So even though you can't do everything anymore once you're in college as a biology major, it is worth your time because you do learn so much and you have doors opened up to you to so many different great career pathways or things that you could do after college. If you're thinking of becoming a biology major and you have questions, let me know in the comments below. If you are a biology major and you have things you wish you would have learned before you started, go ahead and add that as well so other people can hear ideas for things they should know before they become biology majors. Thanks so much for watching. Give this video a like if it's been helpful, and I'll see you later.